एवरीवन, दिस इज राजेश। वेलकम टू द सेकेंड लेक्चर ऑफ एसिड्स, बेसिस एंड सॉल्ट्स। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल सी व्हाट आर इंडिकेटर्स एंड केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एसिड्स एंड बेसिस। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद इंडिकेटर्स। दीज आर द सब्सटेंसेस विच change their color or smell when put into an acid or base. Thus, an indicator tells us whether the substance we are testing is an acid or base by change in its color or smell. Now, there are three types of indicators. They are natural indicators, synthetic indicators and olfactory indicators. Now, natural indicators, as their name suggests, they are found in nature in plants. Litmus, red cabbage leaves extract, flower of hydrangea plant, turmeric, etc. are the examples of natural indicators. Synthetic indicators. Now again, as the name suggests, these are the chemical substances. Methyl orange, phenolphthalein, etc. are the examples of synthetic indicators. And third is olfactory indicators. These are the substances having different order in acid and bases. Onion and vanilla are the best examples of olfactory indicators. Now we will see here how these indicators indicate about the presence of acids or base, or how we can check whether the given solution or given substance is acid or base using these indicators. So let us first start with natural indicators. Now in natural indicator, we will first discuss about the litmus paper or about the litmus. Litmus, naturally it is purple in color. It is made into blue litmus or red litmus for the sake of convenience in detecting the color change. When we put blue litmus paper in an acid, its color changes to red. When we put red litmus in the acid, then you will find there is no change in the color. So what happens in acid? Blue litmus changes to red in color. Similarly, when we put a red litmus in a basic solution, its color changes to blue. But if you put a blue litmus in a basic solution, then its color will remain blue. The second natural indicator is red cabbage leaf. Now, these red cabbage leaves, they are red in color when we put them in acids, and their color changes to green when we put them in a basic solution. Their original color is red only. Now, flower of hydrangea. Flower of hydrangea are generally blue in color, and in acidic solution they do not change their color, that is, they are blue in color when put in acidic solution. But they changes to pink color when we put them in a basic solution. Turmeric. Now, we all know the color of turmeric is yellow. Now when we put turmeric in acidic solution, then there is no change in the color. But when we put turmeric in some basic solution, then its color changes to red. Now let us see about synthetic indicators. Here we are discussing two synthetic indicators. One is phenolphthalein and other is methyl orange. Now, phenolphthalein indicator is colorless in acidic solution, but it gives pink color when we put in basic solution. Similarly, the methyl orange indicator gives red color in acidic solution and it shows yellow color in basic solution. The natural color of phenolphthalein is colorless. Now let us see the olfactory indicators. First we will see about onion. Now onion has a characteristic smell. We all know when we cut onion, we have some smell of onion. Now when we put these onions in acidic solution, then its characteristic smell does not change. That is, we get the characteristic smell when we put it in acidic solution. But when we put the onion in a basic solution, then its characteristic smell vanishes, that we do not get any smell. Similarly, vanilla essence, it again have a characteristic smell. When we put vanilla extract or when we react this vanilla extract with acidic solution, then we see that its smell retains. That is, there is no change in its smell. But when we react it with basic solution, then its smell vanishes. That is, no smell. Similarly, clove oil also retains its smell when put in acidic solution, but it loses its smell when we put it in basic solution. So we have understood how these indicators are useful to check whether the given solution is acidic or basic. You have to remember all the types of indicators and their change of color when put in acid or base, or their smell when put in acid or base. Now there is one more indicator that is called universal indicator that we will see later on in this particular chapter. Now let us move to the chemical properties of acids and bases. Acid react with metals. Now this is first chemical property of acids, that is what happens when acid react with metal. So when acid react with metal, it gives us salt and hydrogen gas. For example, when we react hydrochloric acid with zinc, we get zinc chloride plus hydrogen gas. Similarly, when metal react with bases, then again we will get salt and hydrogen gas. So base, they also react with metal and gives salt and hydrogen gas. So when we react sodium hydroxide, that is NaOH, with zinc, we get sodium zincate, that is Na2ZnO2. Please make a note of this formula, which is sodium zincate, that is Na2ZnO2, and hydrogen gas. Now hydrogen gas released can be tested by bringing a burning candle near a gas bubbles. It burst with a pop sound. We know that only hydrogen gas burst with a pop sound when a burning candle is bring near to it. Now let us see with the help of this experiment how we can conclude that in this particular reaction hydrogen gas is coming out. For this we take few pieces of zinc. Now you can see here zinc granule. So we take few pieces of zinc granule in a boiling tube and add about 5 ml of dilute sulfuric acid to it. We will observe the formation of, in place of dilute sulfuric acid, we can also use hydrochloric acid. So we will observe the formation of gas bubbles. We can see here that small gas bubbles are coming out. So pass the gas bubble formed through the soap solution taking in trough. The gas filled bubbles are formed in the soap solution which rises into air. Now you can see here that these gases, these bubbles when they pass, these gases when they pass through this soap solution, what happens? They form some soap bubbles and these bubbles will move in the upward direction. Now when we bring a burning candle near the gas filled soap bubbles, The gas present in the soap bubble burns with a pop sound. Only the hydrogen gas burns, making a pop sound. This shows that in this reaction, hydrogen gas is releasing. So, we have seen that when acid react with metal or when base react with metal, what we get? We get salt and hydrogen gas. Now let us see the second reaction. Reaction of acids with metal carbonate or metal hydrogen carbonate. When acid react with metal carbonate or metal hydrogen carbonate, we get salt, carbon dioxide and water. For example, when hydrochloric acid react with sodium carbonate, that is Na2CO3, we get sodium chloride plus carbon dioxide plus water. And when we react hydrochloric acid with sodium hydrogen carbonate, we get sodium chloride, carbon dioxide and water. Bases generally do not react with metal carbonate and metal hydrogen carbonate. Now, in this reaction, we are seeing that carbon dioxide gas is releasing. So, how we conclude that the gas released is carbon dioxide? So, for this, we will do a lime water test. Now, when carbon dioxide is passed through the lime water, what we get? We get calcium carbonate and water. Calcium carbonate precipitate forms, which makes the lime water milky. Now, what is lime water? So, lime water is CaOH twice. That is, when we put calcium oxide in water, then we get lime water. Now, when lime water react with carbon dioxide, we get calcium carbonate and water. When we pass excess of carbon dioxide, then this calcium carbonate react with excess of carbon dioxide and gives CaHCO3 twice, that is calcium hydrogen carbonate. Now this calcium hydrogen carbonate is soluble in water, and thus we see that the milky color of water disappears, or milkiness disappears. Now let us again see how we do the experiment. So we take a boiling tube and put about 0.5 gram of sodium carbonate in it. You can see at the bottom we have put some sodium carbonate. Now we add about 2 ml of dilute hydrochloric acid in the boiling tube. We observe that the brisk effervescence of gases is produced. Brisk effervescence means we see that at a rapidly some bubbles are forming and they are moving up. Now we pass this gas through the lime water. The lime water turns milky, showing that the gas which is coming out from this tube is carbon dioxide. Now when we keep on passing carbon dioxide gas through the milky lime water for some more time, the lime water becomes clear again. This shows that the white precipitate of calcium carbonate dissolves on passing excess of carbon dioxide. So this is how we conclude that when acid react with metal carbonate or metal hydrogen carbonate, what it generate? It gives salt plus carbon dioxide plus water. Now let us move to the next reaction. Reaction of acids with bases. Now when acids react with bases, they produce salt and water. The reaction between an acid and base to form salt and water is also called as neutralization reaction. So when HCl hydrochloric acid react with NaOH, we get NaCl plus H2O. So this is strong acid and strong base. They react and gives us salt and water. Now this NaCl salt is neutral salt. Therefore this is called neutralization reaction, because acid, it neutralizes the effect of base, and similarly this base neutralizes the effect of acid. Now if we use strong acid and weak base, then in that case the salt which we obtain is acidic in nature. Similarly, when we use strong base and weak acid, then the salt formed is basic in nature. When we use both strong acid and strong base, then the salt will be neutral. And when we use weak acid and weak base, then again we will get neutral salt and water. So this is reaction of acid with bases. Now the next reaction is reaction of metal oxides with acids. So when metal oxide react with acids, it gives salt and water. Now we already know that when acid react with base, it gives a salt and water. In this reaction also we are getting salt and water. So what you conclude about metallic oxide? You are right, metallic oxide is basic in character. So metallic oxides are basic in nature. Let us take an example, calcium oxide, which is oxide of calcium, that is oxide of metal, metallic oxide. When it reacts with HCl, an acid, we give CaCl2, that is calcium chloride and water. So metallic oxide, when it reacts with acid, it gives salt and water. Similarly, when a non-metallic oxide reacts with base, it gives a salt and water. Again, with the help of same discussion, we can conclude that non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature. So when carbon dioxide, it is oxide of carbon, that is oxide of non-metal. When carbon dioxide, a non-metallic oxide, react with base like CaOH twice, calcium hydroxide gives us calcium carbonate, a salt and water. Right? So this is how metallic oxides react with acids and reaction of non-metallic oxides with bases is. So if we summarize the reaction of acids, then we see that when these acids react with metal, they give salt and hydrogen gas. When they react with metal carbonate or metal hydrogen carbonate, they give us salt, carbon dioxide and water. When acids react with base, they give salt and water. And when acid react with metallic oxide, they give salt and water. Now you can see that salt and water, 1, 2, 3 and 4. In 4 reactions, you are getting salt and water. And in 1 reaction, you are getting salt and hydrogen. So in all the reactions, salt is present. Okay, so this is how you can remember it. First, we have seen 5 reactions, that is 5 different reactions of acids. In all the 5 reactions, the end product is salt. In 4 of the reactions, the end product is water also. And in 1 reaction, it is hydrogen. That is, when it react with metal, it gives a salt and hydrogen. And in 2 reactions, carbon dioxide is also formed. So where carbon dioxide is forming? When it is reacting with metal carbonate or metal hydrogen carbonate. So reaction with metal carbonate or metal hydrogen carbonate, it gives us salt, carbon dioxide and water. When it is reacting with metal, it is giving salt and hydrogen. When it is reacting with metal oxide or when it is reacting with base, it is giving salt and water. So this metallic oxide and this base, their nature is same, that is metallic oxide is basic in nature. Similarly, we summarize the reactions of bases, right? So here, reactions of bases, we have seen that they do not react with metal carbonate and metal hydrogen carbonate. So 2 reactions are wiped out. Now they react with metal, gives salt and hydrogen gas. They react with acid, so they give salt and water. So this reaction is from the previous slide only. There, acid is reacting with base and giving salt and water. Here, we are saying that base is reacting with acid and giving salt and water. And last is, the base, when it react with non-metallic oxide. When it react with non-metallic oxide, what we get? We get salt and water. So this is all about reactions of acids and bases. with different other type of metals or metal oxides or different types of other substances. Right? So, in this lecture, we wind up here. Thank you.